Welcome everyone, this is Ileane from basicblogtips.com. I recently did a video where I showed how to track your conversions in Google Analytics. That video is called Getting Started with Google Analytics Just for Bloggers. And in that video, we talked about tracking conversions using goals in Google Analytics. And one of the goals was the thank you page. Today, we'll see how to set up that thank you page in our dashboard, on our blog, and also how to send people from the AWeber signup form to that thank you page. For that, we're going to have to log in to our AWeber account. So if you're ready, you're logged into your WordPress blog. We'll also need to be logged in to our account on AWeber. So let's get started. Our first step is from our dashboard, and I'm using a test blog today, we will add a new page to the blog. And this will be our thank you page. For now, we're just going to save this page as a draft. But what I want you to see, the very important step that we need to have done here, is that our permalink says thank-you. Once we have that all set, we'll save this draft. We'll come back to this later. Now we're logged in to our AWeber account, and we're on the tabs where we create the forms. So let's create a new web form. And we'll pick one that's really simple. Now from the settings page, see where it says basic thank you page? Do a preview. So this is the page that basically tells the person that what they need to do is activate their subscription by going to their email and confirming by clicking on the link. So we're just going to copy this text just the way it is on this page that AWeber has. That's their default page. Go back over to our blog. That thank you page that we created, let's go to the text version of it. Remember, we saved it as a draft. Now we're going to come back over here. If we want to, we can style it the way they had, you know, make this bold, put links down here for the privacy policy and the no stamp spam policy. Then we'll publish that page. And here's what the finished version of the page will look like. So now let's see this in action. I just filled out the form on my blog. Click the sign up button and bam, it takes me right to the thank you page. So we have to go back over into AWeber to get this to work. So for our thank you page in the AWeber, when we're filling our form out, we're going to use a custom page. And this is where you're going to enter the URL. And notice how I have that slash thank-you. That's important. Now you can call it thanks. You don't have to have the dash in there. But whatever it is over on your blog, whatever you set up as that permalink, that's the same thing you're going to enter in this box. Okay, I have a word of caution for you, so listen up. If you weren't paying attention, now's the time to pay attention. I made this mistake, and I don't want you to make it as well. As bloggers, we're always intuitively opening things in a new window. Don't do that. When you do that, when you click off this box, then you're going to lose your Google Analytics tracking data, and you don't want that to happen. So don't open it in a new window, just leave it there and then go ahead and save the form. Now, typically, you'll want to put that form on the sidebar on your blog. So just click, I will install my form, get that JavaScript snippet, copy it, come back over to the back end of your WordPress blog and go into the appearance and widgets area, then get a text widget, paste your code here, and then you can select whatever sidebar position that you want that sign up form to appear in. Now we can add that goal over in Google Analytics. And this is real important. I've gone over this step in a few videos before, but I never showed you the whole process, and it doesn't hurt to do it one more time. Once you're logged into Google Analytics, you'll go over to your admin area, click on the blog, click on goals. You want to set up as a URL goal. In this case, we're going to give it the name of thank you. You want an active URL destination. Here's your goal URL. You don't have to put your entire URL. You're just going to put that slash thank you that we've been talking about through this whole video. You can make it a head match. Give it a goal value of 1 and save it. Then these are the reports that you will see as a result. And you can navigate over to one of your traffic reports. Make sure you have that goal set clicked on. Then I sort it by the highest percentage that are reaching that thank you page. I happen to have it in this last column. If it's your first goal, it may be in this column. Doesn't matter. You're just going to look for the one that you named thank you. And you can see here, bloggers.com has the highest conversion rate, and then YouTube, and so on down the line. So let's just do a quick review. You're going to set up your thank you page. You'll go over to AWeber, create the form, tell the form that you want it to go to a custom page. You want the thank you page to be a custom page. Then you'll fill that URL in. Then you'll go over to Google Analytics and set up a goal for the thank you page. Don't worry, if you get lost, I have the SlideShare presentation with all the screenshots that you'll need. Also, remember that if at any time you have a question, you can leave a voicemail for me over on my contact page. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see the Send Voicemail button. Just click that on, and that's going to open up SpeakPipe. Turn on your microphone and leave me a recording, and I will answer your question. Sign up for my newsletter. That way you can stay on top of all the latest with blogging, social media, YouTube, and podcasting. And in order to sign up, just go over to basicblogtips.com/email. And I'll chat with you soon.